All right. Right here, I made some adjustment, just one adjustment. The reason why, if you were playing your game yesterday, you should see a leaderboard. Now watch what happens. And I'm gonna show you what an interesting thing I found. Now, as you can see, we don't have a leaderboard over here because this is a very big error on my part. Here in my script for the leaderboard, I put leaderstats.name. I put that to player. What I need to do is on line number 3 in the green words, you need to type out this this right here, leader stats, because that is what Lua has. So that's what Roblox has as leader stats. So for everybody, go ahead and change player from line 3 to leader stats. You should only change what's in green, not anything else. You can change the name score to whatever you want. Only the font that's in green you can change it to. On line number 7. But keep line number 6, 8, and 9 as they are. The only thing you need to be changing as far as the name of what you want to call your score is on line number 7. All right, so now that we have figured out our leaderboard, the next thing we're going to move on to is we're going to add collectibles to our score. Now, there's a couple ways we can do this, but we're going to do this the right way. So I'm going to go back to my platform here. And first off, I need to make sure that it's in the middle because I'm going to start collecting them. Which are, if they're not, I just need to change the positions. So I'm going to go ahead and select one of my coins. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the add object. And I'm going to select script. And what I'm going to change only from the script is I'm going to change it to collectible. I'm not selecting the mesh. I'm only selecting the script so I can change the name. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete print hello world and I'm going to create a new function. So I'm going to type function collectible and I'm going to put in parentheses. Now what I'm going to put in parentheses is part touching because our player is going to touch the coin so we can start adding scores to our leaderboard. Okay, so for line number 2, if part touching dot parent find first child, which is going to be the humanoid. Then we'll press enter and that's going to put a second in on line number 4. So this is the next part that you need to type. For line number 3, we're going to type in local player equals game dot players. Get player from character and we're going to put in part touching dot parent. Let me just zoom it out so you guys can see this line. So this is our next line that we're going to be adding. Line number 3 right here. So we're going to go down to line number 4. We're going to type player dot leader stats dot score dot value equals player dot leader stats dot score dot value plus one. So every time we touch the coin, it's going to add a value of one to our score. Now, if you want to change the value, only thing you need to change is this number right here. That's going to change it to whatever number you have decided to change. On line number five, you're going to type script.parent.destroy. That's for line number five only. Yes, that's going to delete the part because we don't need that anymore. And that's going to add to our score. All right, so the final line that we are going to be typing is for line number nine, and that is going to be this. Script.parent.touch. And then connect collectible. Need this in parentheses. This is the last line we're going to type right here, line number nine. If you select your coin and you go down to your properties, you're going to see a little behavior. It says behavior. Now, if you feel like you're going too far, just click on the arrows on everything else so you can just like close the windows. You should only be under behavior, and the only thing you should turn off is can collide. Turn off can collide and make sure anchored and archivable is turned on. Like, these are the only two that need to be turned on. Everything else needs to be turned off. Now, if I go back and I play my game, I should be able to collect the coins based on where they are. Now, as you can see, I can't collect them because they might be too far from where I'm walking. So in this any case, if you feel like your character is basically out of place, just move your coins to the middle or somewhere until he is able to collect them. So let me see if I can collect them now. So as you can see, I did, because my score went from 0 to 1. So watch again. See, I have 0. If I walk towards a coin, it went from 0 to 1. So my script works. Now, let's just say if you only have one certain coin, just one coin on your platform, you can duplicate it. Basically, just right-click on this coin or whatever coin you have and select duplicate, and you can just move it with your move tool. And watch what happens. I am going to move towards the right, and as you can see, I collected 3 coins now.
Be sure to join Tech Dev Academy's workshops and camps, and also read some great articles on their blog page.